Mike Royko is known for the many daily columns he wrote, as well as for being the voice of the working class. He was born on September 19, 1932 in Chicago, Illinois. Growing up, he enjoyed reading the work of Irv Kupp, a columnist after whom he is said to have modeled his own work after. He attended Wright Junior College, but dropped out his second year to join the Air Force. He worked as a radio operator and also wrote for the base's newspaper at O'Hare Airport. In 1956, he left the Air Force when he was offered a job to be a nighttime reporter for the Chicago Daily News. After gaining this experience, he became a writer for the paper in 1963. Royko was known to be a very witty and sarcastic reporter, and the very first column he wrote, titled The Daily Beat, was very popular and received more attention on page 14 than the headlines on the front page did. Royko was then promoted to page 3, writing two columns a week. Royko eventually moved up to writing a daily column 5 days a week, and by the end of his life, he had written an estimated over 7,500 daily columns in his 30 years of journalism.
The star here, and I guess I should start by reading a couple of clips about you. You write about everybody else. This one happens to be about you. A profile in the Washington Journalism Review, and it says, around Chicago, Royko is as big a legend as Carl Sandburg, Al Capone, or Richard Daley. His column is the best read feature in either of the city's two remaining dailies. Esquire magazine once called Royko the man who owns Chicago. Did you pay this guy off, or was all this stuff true?
Topics he wrote most frequently about were Mayor Richard Daley and Chicago politics, national politics, sports, race, the differences in generations, cultural trends, and animals. He frequently published and commented on letters from his readers, and in 1972 he was awarded the Pulitzer Prize for commentary. He won many other awards, including the Washington Journalism Review's Best Columnist in America Award, the Ernie Pyle Award, and the H.L. Mencken Award. He also wrote a book about Major Daley called Boss, Richard J. Daley of Chicago.
He, of course, was my hero.
When the Chicago Daily News went under, Royko went to work as a columnist for the Chicago Sun-Times. Here, he published columns that instigated criminal investigations and influenced elections. Royko left the paper when Rupert Murdoch bought it and moved to work for the Chicago Tribune. In 1985, Royko married Judy Art and had two children. Mike Royko died when he suffered from an aneurysm on April 29, 1997. Mike Royko's name lives on through his work, a large amount of which was republished after his death. His dedication to his work and his witty style made him a great and memorable journalist that he was.